Welcome back to our Med Smarter lecture series, where we're taking a smarter approach to preparing future physicians. Before we get started, if you'll take just a quick minute and click that like button, and also subscribe and turn the bell on so that you'll be notified when we post new videos. Let's look at some subtypes of chlamydia, in particular, Chlamydia trachomatis. And we're going to look at the serotypes of Chlamydia trachomatis to see the different types, what they cause, and some other facts about them. So the first one we'll discuss are types A, B, and C. So the serotype A, B, and C give us a chronic infection, and specifically they cause blindness due to the follicular conjunctivitis oftentimes seen in Africa. All right, so a way to remember types A, B, and C is that you have A, B, C has Africa where it's located, blindness is an association due to follicular conjunctivitis, and it's a chronic infection. So A, B, C, Africa, blindness, chronic infection. The next serotypes we'll discuss are types D through K. These cause urethritis and pelvic inflammatory disease. It can also lead us to ectopic pregnancies due to scarring, neonatal pneumonia with eosinophilia, and neonatal conjunctivitis that typically shows up between 1 and 2 weeks after birth. This is due to the exposure to the chlamydia bacteria during birth as the baby passes through the birth canal of the infected mother. You can think of types D through K as just being everything else outside of your ABC, Africa blindness, chronic infections. Neonatal disease here can be acquired through the infected birth canal, as we discussed just a minute ago. And then finally, the other serotype we'll discuss is types L1, L2, and L3. These are specifically going to cause lymphogranuloma venereum. And what lymphogranuloma venereum is, they're small, painless ulcers that you see on the genitals. What they're going to lead to then is swollen, painful inguinal lymph nodes. Then those lymph nodes can ulcerate, which is what we see, and we call those buboes. All right, so those painful inguinal lymph nodes are called buboes. And to treat the lymphogranuloma venereum, we're just going to treat that with doxycycline. If you found this material helpful for your studying, please like and consider subscribing to the channel. Also, share this video so that more people can benefit from it like you have.